Sweden has done so many different great things to bolster its military. And with that, we continue to learn more about the Stridsvagn 122 and find out the differences between it and the Leopard 2 tank, which it's built around. How's it going, everybody? My name is Dave Wapple. Now, here on FTD Facts, we usually talk about people, cultures, militaries, and all that stuff. And if that's your sort of bag, you want to hit that subscribe button. Now, for our regular guys, just letting you know, we're doing things a little bit shorter here because we're doing shorter videos so we can get new content out to a diverse amount of audiences, which we have. And with that, we're going to add another video to our Sweden military playlist. And just so you guys know about that playlist, it'll be in the cards throughout this video or in the description box below. You guys can check out. But today, we're talking about the Stridsvagn 122. So actually, guys, before we get into this video, considering we're talking about the Swedes and how the Swedes are Vikings, I just want to let you guys know about one of our cool sponsors. What you guys are looking at now is a browser game called Viking War of Clans, and we've actually had them here on the channel before. A lot of our fan base originally liked it, so we wanted to bring this back to you guys again. For myself, I've actually played Vikings multiple times. It's actually a really addictive game. And one thing that I do like about this game is that I can play it on my computer instead of just sitting on front of my Xbox. Because of that, I get a more modern, rich, and fantastic graphics, and just a more unique gameplay by using the mouse. Another really awesome feature with Vikings War of Clans is its social features, such as working with other people. As a matter of fact, there are more people playing the game Vikings in today's world than there was for the total population of Vikings that ever lived. Another great thing with Viking War of Clans is that it's absolutely free to play. You guys can head on down to the description box below. I've got a link right there. And bonus, you get an extra 200 gold coins to start your adventure. It's a really fun, addicting game, and you guys will absolutely have a blast playing it. So let's get started. We're getting right into it. So the Stridsvagn 122 is basically your Swedish version of the Leopard 2. Sometimes people actually refer to this as the Leopard 2S, as a matter of fact. It's also considered the most armored version of a Leopard 2 of any other variant in the entire world. And for this video, we're going to look at the differences between this and the Leopard 2A5, which is the more advanced version of the Leopard 2 tanks. Bit of a backstory, the Leopard 2 was originally brought into service in Germany in 1979, and for the Leopard 2S, it wasn't brought in until about 1997, when Sweden wanted a modified version of the tank for its style of fighting, which was mostly forested locations and urban combat. As for the Leopard 2A5, this was another version with heavy upgrades, and it was introduced into Germany in 1995. This particular version introduced the wedge-shaped frontal armor that you see on most Leopard 2s nowadays, and that's somewhat the same armor that the Leopard 2S has. It just has a little bit more, and I'm going to get into that. Because what makes these two different? Well, let's take a look. Firstly, when it comes to cost, the Stridsvagn 122 comes in at approximately $5.74 million, where the Leopard 2A5 is a little bit more with $6.86 million. And although the weight is slightly different compared to the two, the length and the width comes in generally the same, both having a length of 9.97 meters and a width of 3.75 meters. As for the height, they both equal 3 meters for both versions. For the 122s, though, they are a little bit heavier, coming in at 62.5 tons, whereas the Leopard 2A5 is a little bit under at 62.3 tons. Why is there a major difference between the weight? Well, it's basically armor. Both tanks use what is known as third-generation composite armor, but the Stridsvagn has some major upgrades in different places. For example, it's added increased armor at the top of the turret and the front hull, with about 3 tons worth being added. As well, on top of that, when it comes to the crew hatches, they are considered to be much thicker. Now, for armaments, these two tanks use the same. Both the Leopard 2A5 and the Stridsvagn 122 use the 120mm smoothbore gun, both having 42 rounds. For the machine guns, they are both 7.62 in size and generally have around the same amount of ammunition. The power and weight, however, is different for the Stridsvagn 122 simply because it is slightly heavier, making it have 24 horsepowers per ton, whereas the Leopard 2A5 has 24.08 horsepowers per ton. Range is the same, coming in at around 550 kilometers, with the same amount of fuel within the tank coming in at 1,200 liters. Now, speed, however, this is where things get a little bit tricky. Now, I've heard that the Stridsvagn 122 is a little bit slower, coming in at 68 kilometers per hour, whereas the Leopard 2A5 can go about 4 kilometers faster at 72 kilometers per hour. However, some reports have also stated that the Stridvon is capable of going up to 72, but many other reports counter that, so not entirely sure on that one. But one of the most important features when it comes to the Stridvon 122 is the side smoke dispensers. That's how you can really tell the difference between a Leopard 2A5 and a Stridvon 122. This is because on the side for protection, the Stridvon uses what is known as the French Galax smoke dispensers. It also has been upgraded with a new fire control system and Swedish radio, and among a few other things. Both of them are capable of doing very similar things and are quite reliable to the people that use them. So either way, guys, that is one of our short videos here of looking at the differences between these two individual tanks. What did you guys think of this video? Hope you guys like it. And guys, feel free to leave a comment for which one you think is better. And on top of that, if you want to recommend any other things that we should compare and find out the differences between, feel free to leave it down there. But my name is Dave Wapple. Thanks for hanging out and be sure to check out the playlist before you go. So here you go, guys. Here are the playlists. And yeah, if it's your first time here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification button. These playlists, however, we've tailored them. So if you're into military from Sweden, you guys will really like this stuff. If you just are from Sweden, you want to learn more about the country, well, you want to just check out the Swedish playlist because it's really cool. So thanks for watching. We'll see you later. Bye.